fitted around me now. He's got the new kickoff thing, right? Dude, I can't! It's too good! He hits it fast. I don't know how else to say it. It's extremely fast. I don't have that skill, Kyrie. I can't do the flip cancels he does. See, the problem is even if I compensate for it, he can adjust. See, I don't know what to do. Like, it looks like he's not gonna get it. It's very mentally weird because it looks like he's not gonna get it. Alright, so I know what to do this time.
Nope.
All right, guess not. It's legit very fast.
Remember the old fast kickoff tutorials from 2015 or 2016 where you could just kind of flip into the corner of the ball, and a lot of the time it actually worked because everyone back then did slower kickoffs where they only flipped into it once. That can still work at the lower levels, but at the higher levels, players adapted by doing a kickoff where they flip twice to get to the ball a little bit faster. Since then, there hasn't been any huge breakthroughs or ways to get basically a free goal off a kickoff at the higher levels, but I actually have kind of found one here. This is a legit kickoff that really does work against a lot of Grand Champs, and I'm gonna be telling you guys all about it and doing my best to teach you guys how to do it. First things first, I'm not trying to say I invented all aspects of this, but I'm saying I just discovered a faster way to touch the ball on kickoffs, which can lead to some easy goals versus Grand Champs. It's like if an archaeologist digs up dinosaur bones, they didn't invent the dinosaur bones, they simply discovered that they were there. I know that was kind of a weird analogy, but that explains it kind of well. So before we get into the specifics here, I wanted to say I really did debate making this video, because I know once it's out, people will know how to do it, and it could become much more mainstream for high level players, and people will likely try to figure out some ways to counter it, but as of right now, October 12th, 2019, it's extremely overpowered because I'm really the only person in Rocket League doing this kickoff at the moment. So my opponents aren't really sure what they're up against, but once this video's out, that could be totally different. So just kind of as a baseline here, I wanted to say a few things. First of all, this only works on the two diagonal kickoffs. I've tried everything to make this work on the other kickoff spawns, but against Grand Champs, this simply won't work. Like I said, if you're playing against much lower ranked players, it could work on the other kickoffs because they don't necessarily know how to hit a very efficient kickoff themselves. Next, if you execute this kickoff properly, it actually hasn't been that risky for me to do at all. It's actually very rare to get scored on from this kickoff, which is actually really surprising. I'll talk about this and explain why this is at the end of the video. Next, just a little misconception is that the opponent has to have a slow kickoff for this to work, and that's initially what I thought as well. Like, you think they'd have to be doing something wrong in order for this to work, and that's actually not true at all. Like, if they do have a slower kickoff or some little delay in their kickoff, this is basically guaranteed to work, but you can quote me on what I'm about to say here. I could watch a replay in super slow motion of a player doing a certain kickoff, and as a Rocket League coach, I would tell them that they're doing the correct kickoff. The kickoff they're doing, there's absolutely nothing wrong with it, and you shouldn't be losing the kickoff, and the speed flip kickoff can still counter it and not even give them a chance to touch the ball. So just to clarify, this does work against the normal kickoffs if you do it perfectly. I honestly feel kind of bad now because in my kickoff tutorial on some of the diagonal kickoffs, I educate you guys and tell you this is the correct way to do a kickoff, and it is, or it was, because the speed flip kickoff I'm talking about can actually work against that and get you directly scored on. Next, I just wanted to say that this doesn't work every single time. In a game like Rocket League, there's nothing you can do that's gonna work every single time. Straight up, every kickoff has some sort of counter to it that the opponent can do to not let you score a goal. I'll touch on this and get into the details later in the video, but generally, if the opponent does a diagonal flip on the kickoff as opposed to doing a front flip, sometimes it won't work out perfectly. And by it not working out perfectly, I mean they'll probably get a little touch on the ball and you won't be scoring a completely free goal. So it not working out perfectly is basically the equivalent of a normal kickoff. Remember, we're already at an extreme advantage just talking about the possibility of getting free goals against the Grand Champ. I don't want to get your hopes up too high though, this is extremely hard to do. Just be aware, this is ridiculously difficult. I went all the way down to low champion 2 in 1v1s because if you don't do this kickoff 100% perfectly, it'll turn into a pretty bad kickoff. But I don't care about my rank too much, and I had a little faith, and after about a week straight of deranking because of it, something finally just clicked and I got it down consistently. Okay, so there are three different ways to do this kickoff, and all of them require a certain type of flip, which I'm gonna be calling the speed flip. To really understand everything about this flip and for it to naturally develop in your gameplay, to understand how it works, when it works, and why you could be doing it, I'd say you need at least 3,000 hours in the game to really fully grasp it, but you can still watch this video and kind of artificially know how to do it, if that makes sense. Now, I originally came across this type of flip because it's similar to a flip cancel front flip, which can make shots and redirects a little more powerful and accurate and give your car less recoil so you can get a quicker recovery. So I've been doing that for a super long time, and once I started learning pre-flips, which are a totally different thing, I started naturally canceling my flips on diagonal dodges to reach the ball at different angles. But it wasn't until the Lean Carew challenge when I figured out executing a perfect flip cancel diagonal flip, or speed flip, is actually faster than any other flip. Shot number 30 in particular, everyone was struggling with, and Lean Carew mentioned that you can only touch the ball with a certain type of flip, which at the time seemed really unnatural and clunky, but it did get the job done for the few high level players that could actually get it down. So the flip cancel diagonal flip, which I'm going to be calling speed flip because it's a lot quicker to say, is the main portion of this kickoff. So here's how you can do a speed flip. First, you want to do a completely normal diagonal flip. Most of you should be able to do that. Jump, hold up into the left, and jump again. The next step is canceling it. And to cancel any flip, you have to hold your left stick in the opposite direction of where it came from immediately after you dodge. So for a forward left diagonal dodge, you can cancel it by holding your left stick down into the right. If you just do that though, you won't get a really clean landing. So what you need to do is after the cancel, air roll slightly to land on all four wheels, and as you're landing, hold power slide as well to keep as much momentum from the flip as possible. I have both air roll and power slide bound to the left button, so that makes the last part a bit easier, but like I said, this is nowhere near as easy as it sounds, and it's even harder to do consistently. And if you don't do it perfectly during the kickoff, there's a good chance you get scored on. I made a little training pack for you guys so you can test to see if you're doing the most efficient flip in Rocket League correctly. So in all these examples and on all the kickoff goals I've scored with it, I've been doing a left diagonal flip cancel, and I can confirm that the left one works for both diagonal kickoff spawns. So the first shot in the pack here, if you can touch the ball without the time running out, you can do it correctly. And in a game, you can only get goals from this if you can consistently touch the ball that fast. I've gotten somewhat consistent at it, as you can see here, but remember, this is the result of 6 months knowing how to do this in games and 2 weeks of just focusing on the speed flip to get the muscle memory down. Some of you guys may be able to touch it after 5 or 10 minutes, and for others, it may take a few days or even a few weeks. The next two shots are just the diagonal kickoff spawns where you can continue practicing. Now, applying this to a kickoff, you want to boost to the 12 boost pad and start your speed flip from there. But if you just speed flip into the middle of the ball, that'll get you the first touch before the opponent, but there's a good chance he'll get a little touch on it as well. By the way, like I said in the beginning, we're assuming the opponent is doing a normal front flip kickoff. The key to not let the opponent touch the ball is to aim your speed flip where you can land at the very edge of the ball, and that's why this kickoff is so hard. Not only do you have to know how to do the speed flip itself, but you have to know how to aim it and land it exactly where you want it to. Okay, so if you do everything I said perfectly and your opponent does a front flip kickoff, which is super common at any rank, you have a decent chance to score yourself a free goal. The first way and easiest way to do this is to hit the close edge of the ball and bounce it off the sidewall. If you do the flip correctly, it should usually bounce off the wall instead of rolling up the wall. So the ball will come back to the middle and you should have time to get a goal before the opponent can recover. The only thing I sometimes don't like about this one is you'll get the ball past the opponent and rarely they'll get a bump or demo on you, so you don't get a chance to capitalize on the open net. The second way to do this is to aim to hit the ball at the far edge, and this one is slightly harder to execute in my opinion because there's more distance to travel, which potentially gives the opponent more time to touch the ball. But if you get it right, the payoff is huge. If you manage to get it, the ball is either going straight into the goal or bouncing off the post or backboard right in front of the net, so it should be a free goal unless you're like me in this case and don't know how to score those. I've gotten the chance to save a lot of replays and watch it back from my opponent's perspectives because I want to know why and when this works, and of course there are exceptions, but for the most part, here's something I found. If the opponent is doing a front flip kickoff and at the ending portion of their flip they still have 16 or more boosts left in the tank, you can get it right past them and put it near the goal. Having a little over 16 boosts in the tank after you flip, by the way, is a completely normal thing to do. So that's what the common theme seems to be to allow kickoff 2 to get us a direct goal. Remember though, like I said, when they do a quick diagonal flip, that can usually counter these kickoffs, but if you did the movements correctly, the best thing about these kickoffs is the ball always seems to bounce in a somewhat safe spot, and you have so much momentum built up that you can almost always get back in time. Once I got the kickoff consistent, it surprisingly hasn't been risky for me to go for. In less than a week, I've scored over 150 goals and maybe given up around 10. The third and final kickoff is basically the same speed flip, but you land and hold power slide and flip again and hit it in the middle of the ball. This one with two flips is a lot safer and will frequently win you the kickoff because you get the first touch. It's lower risk, but lower reward. It's still a great kickoff, and I've already seen some pros start doing it. This last week, though, has honestly felt like I'm hacking the game or something, especially for the first two kickoffs. There aren't really any bad things about the kickoff, aside from the fact that it's insanely hard to get it down. So let me know what you think of these kickoffs in the comment section below, and don't forget to like the video, and if you enjoyed it, don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you're new here. Peace.